Hello everyone, the topic for today is validation of Baveno 6 criteria for screening of esophageal varices in a cohort of South Asian patients with compensated CLD. My moderator is Dr. Schweb, sir. I will be talking about this in the following headings. These are the authors. Variceal hemorrhage is a major complication of cirrhosis and carries significant morbidity and mortality. Portal hypertension causes gastroesophageal varices, which can be detected by upper GI scopy. But upper GI scopy is an expensive procedure and also is an invasive procedure which is not free of complications. Many of the patients who undergo the procedure do not have varices or they have small varices which do not warrant treatment. So there is an increased burden on the healthcare system as well as on the patient. Hence a non-invasive test or marker becomes essential to screen patients to identify who requires upper GI endoscopy. Baveno is a portal hypertension consensus. The current Baveno 6 consensus states that a transient elastography value of less than 20 kilopascals and a platelet count of more than 150,000 does not warrant screening endoscopy. But this is based on evidences mostly from European centers. So the following study attempts to validate the same in a cohort of South Asian population. The research methodology. The objective of the study was to validate the Baveno 6 consensus in South Asian population and also to determine variables that could predict the presence of high-risk varices. High-risk varices are grade 3 esophageal varices or grade 2 varices with red whale markings or any gastric varices. 375 patients were included for the study. I'll later talk about how many patients fulfilled the Baveno criteria and how many patients did not fulfill the Baveno 6 criteria but still had high risk varices. This study was conducted between September 2016 and August 2017. Patients with chronic liver diseases that attended the OP at the Department of Medical Gastroenterology in Trivandrum Government Medical College and who had liver stiffness measurement of more than 10 kilopascals and had laboratory tests and upper GI endoscopy performed within 6 months of TE were included. The cutoff of 10 kilopascals was kept because this was defined by the Baveno 6 criteria. The probability of having compensated alcoholic liver disease is very low if the liver stiffness measurement is less than 10 kilopascal, and Baveno 6 also mentions that patients with liver stiffness measurement in between 10 and 15 are likely to have compensated alcoholic chronic liver disease. This study has excluded patients with decompensated cirrhosis. Decompensated means someone who was presented with ascites or presented with icterus or who was in hepatic encephalopathy. And also exclude patients with portal or splenic vein thrombosis and a history of splenectomy or liver transplantation. The protocol, transient elastography was performed using FibroScan after at least 4 hours of fasting. Liver stiffness measurement was taken from the right lobe of the liver. Esophageal varices grading was noted as per standard criteria and data pertaining to etiology, LFT, RFT, CBC, INR was noted for all patients. The routine laboratory values was compared between patients with and without HRV. Patients also underwent OGD scopy and grading of varices was done by standard criteria. Potential number of endoscopies which could have been avoided by various methods, say excluding TE and including platelet count and MELE score, was also calculated. Statistical analysis was performed using the SPSS package. The comparison between groups were performed using Mann-Whitney U-test for non-parametric tests and Fischer's exacta test for proportion. The area under ROC curve was constructed for validation study. ROC stands for Receiver Operating Characteristic Curve, which illustrates the diagnostic ability of a classifier system. Baseline characteristics of the test is summarized in this table. So this table shows that several patients are included in the study from various etiologies including ethanol, including non-alcoholic fatty liver disease and viral hepatitis induced chronic liver disease. The main etiology of compensated cirrhosis in this study was hepatitis B, followed by hepatitis C, non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, and also alcohol. From the previous table, we gather that 266 patients fulfilled Baveno criteria to rule out high-risk varices. Among those, only 4 patients had high-risk varices. So the negative predictive value of this was 99%. Now, in hepatitis B and C patients, the transient yeast elastography was done before starting antivirus. This is of interest. 109 patients were out of Baveno 6 criteria, and among those, 80 patients had high-risk viruses. So 70% of the endoscopies could be avoided. No patient with MELD score of 6 showed high-risk viruses irrespective of the platelet count. So the sensitivity and negative predictive value for MELD is equal to 6 is almost 100%. No patient with MELD score of 7 and platelet count of more than 150,000 had high-risk viruses, while only one patient out of 233 patients with platelet count of more than 150,000 had high-risk viruses whose MELD was 8. By using MELD is equal to 6 or MELD less than 8 and platelet count of more than 150,000 criteria for high-risk viruses, we can predict which patient requires endoscopy. So among all patients, by using MELD score and platelet count, 67% of screening endoscopies could have been circumvented. While using the Baveno 6 criteria, 70% of the endoscopies could have been circumvented, which is comparable. The AUROC for compensated cirrhosis was 0.91. That means this classifier system is good. AUC ranges in value from 0 to 1. It is a model for predicting. So if the value is 100%, that means this classifier system is excellent. This table shows how Baveno 6 criteria performs in compensated chronic liver disease patients of various etiologies. So from this, we can almost say that the negative predictive value is high irrespective of the etiology. Okay, this is the ROC curve. It uses Baveno criteria to rule out high-risk varices in compensated cirrhosis patients. Coming to the merits of the study suggested that there is a role for non-invasive markers in identifying patients at low risk of having clinically significant varices and who can avoid safely screening endoscopy. From this study, we also get to know a new strategy using MELD and platelet count, which can be used when transient elastography is not available. So using MELD and platelet count, we can safely know who can avoid endoscopy in resource-constrained settings. This study also incorporates compensated cirrhotics from various etiologies, virus-induced, alcohol-induced, any non-alcoholic fatty liver disease patients. So the demerits of this study is the subjective reporting of the size of varices carries some bias. Next, the liver stiffness measurement criteria for cirrhosis in South Asian population has not been defined, and we have used the data from Baveno 6 and extrapolated it here. Coming to related studies, this study is taken from the Journal of Hepatology. A combined model based on spleen stiffness measurement and Baveno criteria to rule out high-risk varices in advanced chronic liver disease. This study shows that a non-invasive prediction model combining splenic stiffness measurement with Baveno 6 criteria may be useful to rule out high-risk varices and could make it possible to avoid a significant large number of unnecessary upper GI scopies compared to Baveno 6 criteria only. Another related study uses non-invasive measurements of liver stiffness measurement and platelet count in non-alcoholic fatty liver disease patients to rule out high-risk varices or varices needing treatment by using a NAFLD cirrhosis criteria. Okay, the last study tries to assess Baveno 6 criteria versus expanded Baveno 6 criteria in excluding high-risk varices. So essentially, Baveno 6 criteria can be used as a triage test to reduce the number of unnecessary endoscopies. But make note that all these previous related studies have been done in the European population, not in the South Asian population. So this study, what I've just discussed, has reiterated the Baveno 6 criteria in South Asian population. Thank you.